Good morning all of you. In today's class, we will be discussing the concept of earthing. What does it mean by earthing or grounding? So you might have all seen earth pits at your home and also at our college. So beside our college building and around our college building, there are lot of earth pits. What is the purpose of those earth pits? The purpose of earthing is to protect the consumer from electrical shocks. When earthing is provided, the consumer or the user gets protected if there is any leakage in the equipment. So we will see the definition of earthing. The process of connecting the metallic frame of electrical equipment or some electrical part of the system to the earth, that is soil, is called grounding or earthing. Let us see the definition one more time. The process of connecting the metallic frame that is non-current carrying part of the electrical equipment or some electrical part of the system, example neutral or neutral point in a star connected system or one of the secondary of the transformer to a earth or soil, is called as grounding or earthing. Generally, the potential of the earth is considered as zero for all practical purposes. Let us understand the scenario using a simple diagram. For suppose, this is the equipment, this is the body of the equipment, and because of some fault in the equipment, there is leakage. That means the electrical wires gets connected to the body of the equipment. So the body of the equipment will develop some voltage. And if at all a user comes and touches the body of the equipment, the user gets shock. That means the current passes through the hand of the consumer and through his leg to the ground. Thereby, the consumer gets electric shock. So this is the transformer, and through it is supply is given to the load. So this is the case if at all the equipment is not grounded. So how the person is getting shock? If there is any leakage in the equipment, that is if the insulation of the wire of the equipment gets damaged, and if the conductor of the equipment gets connected to the body of the equipment will get shock. I mean, if a person comes in contact with the body of the equipment, he will get shock. So this is the case if at all no earthing is provided in the house. So come to this scenario. In this scenario, the equipment is provided with grounding. So this is called as grounding. The equipment is connected to the ground, so that is called as grounding. So how an equipment is provided earth, we will see. Okay. So in this case, if at all there is due to some internal fault, the conductor gets connected to the body of the equipment, and if at all a user gets user comes in contact with the equipment, even there is some malfunction in the equipment, even if that equipment body is getting electrical shock, and if that consumer comes in contact with the body, the consumer will not get shock, because here you can see here the equipment is provided with grounding. So now the fault current or the leakage current will pass to the ground from the body of the equipment. The consumer or the user gets protected here. So here you can see the fault current passes through the earthing. So that is the advantage of providing earthing. So in your households also, you might have observed sometimes your cooler cooler that is used in home, when we touch the cooler, the cooler will get a shock. So if proper earthing is not provided, then the consumer will get shock if he touches the equipment. So if there is any failure of the insulation of the conductor, and if the conductor gets connected to the body of the equipment, if any consumer or the user touches the body of the equipment, he will get shock if at all earthing is not provided. So we'll, in this slide you can see see the 3-pin plug. So you all know a 3-pin plug. This is called as a 3-pin plug. So in this 3-pin plug, these two terminals are phase and neutral, that is meant for providing power supply to the equipment. And this third pin, that is the bigger pin, is called as earth pin. So this earth pin is meant for protection. So from the earth pit, a conductor is provided to the socket which is mounted on the wall. And if this, when and if we insert this plug to the socket of the wall, a conductor is run through the wire of the equipment, and it is connected to the body of the equipment. So what is the purpose? So if at all, if you see the wire of a fridge or a cooler, it has got three wires. So two wires are meant for phase and neutral, and the third wire is for earthing. So the third wire is connected to the body of the equipment, and that is connected to the third pin, this pin. And when you insert this plug in the into the wall of the socket, through the socket, that is through the earth pin, one more wire is connected to the earth or the earth bed, which is dig outside of your house. For suppose if there is any leakage, like this, if there is any loose connection or leakage of or damage of insulation around a conductor, and if the conductor gets in contact to the body of the equipment, then if at all a consumer touches the body of the equipment, he will get shock if earthing is not provided. If earthing is provided, whatever the fault current that is there, that will flow through the earth to the ground. So that is the purpose of the third pin. Which is provided for a 3-pin plug. So the third pin is meant for protection. So not only in our household, to all the motors, wherever there is three wires that are there for a single phase equipment, you can understand that the third pin is meant for protection. So simply you can understand that the third pin is meant to protect the user from getting electrical shock in case if there is any damage to the conductor of the equipment. In industries also, there are lot of casings, that means the switches which are enclosed in the casing, all those casing or boxes are connected to ground. Therefore if an equipment is grounded or earthed, the body of the equipment will be at earth potential, that is zero. We'll come back to the definition of earthing. So if you see here, the process of connecting the metallic frame of electrical equipment or some electrical part of the system to the earth is called grounding or earthing. So in industries, the body of the equipment or the terminal boxes are generally earthed. That is, if the user touches the equipment or body of the equipment, he will not get electrical shocks if there are any leakages in the conductors present in the terminal box or the equipment body. So if you see the definition, non-current carrying part means the body of the equipment. Generally, the body of the equipment is not supposed to carry any current. Non-current carrying part means, the example is the body of the fridge or the body of the cooler, that is outer casing is called as a non-current carrying parts. And if you see the neutral part of a star connected system, if you remember the star and delta connection, the star connection has got neutral, and generally the neutral is also earthed. At the distribution transformers, if you observe, the neutral is generally connected to earth pit. So beside distribution transformer also, you can see the neutral wire is connected to the earth pit. Next time when you visit any places or big factories or a distribution transformer, try to observe the earth pit which is there beside it. You can observe a earth rod there. Generally the neutral of the transformer is connected to the earth pit. Next, the potential of earth is generally considered as zero. Generally the potential of earth, that is voltage of earth, is considered as zero, that is at 0 volts. And this diagram we have already seen. In the next diagram, so this is a 3-pin plug. Next we'll see the important points. Earthing is to connect any electrical equipment to earth. Earthing is to connect any electrical equipment to earth with a very low resistance wire, making it to attain earth potential. So earthing means connecting the body of the equipment through a very low resistance wire to attain earth potential. That is, making the body of the equipment to attain earth potential. So why this is done? This ensures safe discharge of electric energy due to failure of the insulation line coming in contact with casing. For suppose take your fridge, if at all if there is any failure of the electric wire in the fridge will get electric shock. So to protect the user, earthing is provided. So if earthing is provided, if there is any leakage in the conductor material, that electric current will pass from the body of the equipment to the ground. Therefore, if any user comes and touches the equipment also, he will not get shock. Next point. Earthing brings the potential of the body of the equipment to zero, that is to the earth potential, thus protecting the operating personnel against the electrical shock. So if a equipment is provided with earthing, the body of the equipment will be maintained at zero potential or earth potential. So therefore, if any user comes and touches the equipment also, he will not get electric shock. Next, the earth resistance is affected by the following factors. So the earth resistance is affected by following factors. So material and the properties of earth, that is wire and electrode. Next, temperature and moisture content of the soil, depth of the pit, quantity of charcoal used. So all this you understand once we see what is meant by earthing. So generally, when earthing is done, it should provide very low resistance. So if it will not provide low resistance, then there is no use of earthing. So the earth resistance is influenced by material properties of earth. That is, whether it is a rocky soil or normal soil, or it is a sandy soil, and wire and electrodes that are used
temperature and moisture content of the soil, whether the soil is dry or wet. Next, depth of the pit. What is the depth of the pit? Quantity of charcoal that is used. What is the amount of charcoal that is used? So all these will influence the earth resistance. So generally the earth resistance should be very low to give proper earthing. Generally it should be less than 5 ohms. Necessity of earthing. What is the purpose of providing earthing? To protect the operating personnel from the danger of shock. Okay, to protect the operating personnel from the danger of shock. To maintain line voltage constant under unbalanced load condition. So even under unbalanced load condition also the line voltage will be maintained constant. Okay, that means simply you can understand that to maintain a constant voltage even at the time of faults, earthing is useful. Next, to avoid risk of fire due to earth leakage currents through unwanted paths. For suppose if earthing is not provided, if there are any leakage currents through the body of the equipment, those leakage currents will develop temperature and it will cause fire hazards. So earthing will avoid the fire hazards. Next, it is for the protection of equipment. Extra protection of large building and all machines fed from overhead lines against lightning. So in some big side tall buildings also, at the top of the building they will provide lightning arresters. So the purpose of those lightning arresters are, if there is any lightning that falls on a building, that lightning will be bypassed to the ground without causing any damage to the building. So simply we can understand that the purpose of earthing is to protect the users or the operating personnel in industries and in substations, to maintain the line voltage constant, that is second point. See, the point is, for suppose some rain is falling in rainy season, if one conductor and cuts and falls on the ground, we can say there is fault on the system. During this scenario, the voltage on the other two healthy phases will increase if proper earthing is not provided. That is, if the neutral of the system is not connected to earth, the voltage of the healthy phases will increase beyond rated voltage. If proper earthing is provided during that condition also, the voltage on the healthy phases will be constant, thereby safeguarding the equipment connected to the healthy phases. So that is the explanation of the second point. We will see the next slide. What are the various methods of earthing in common use? So these are the common ways of providing earthing. First one is pipe earthing. First one is plate earthing. Second is pipe earthing. Third is rod earthing. Fourth is strip or wire earthing. We'll be seeing one by one these different types of earthings. So plate earthing. So what is meant by a plate earthing? We'll understand this plate earthing using this diagram. So if you see here, this is called as a plate earthing. So this is a electrical plate that is used, and this electrical plate is connected to a GI pipe. See, GI means galvanized iron, so GI pipe. So this plate is a copper plate which are having dimensions 60 cm × 60 cm × 3.18. So with these dimensions, so here 60 cm × 60 cm × 3.18 mm, that is the dimensions of the plate. So this plate is strongly welded to a GI pipe, and this is placed in a pit which is having a depth of 3 meters. So generally a pit of more than 3 meters depth, nearly 3.5 meters depth, is dug, and in that pit generally
mixture of salt and charcoal is poured in that pit. So why salt and charcoal is poured is to increase the conductivity of the earth or to decrease the resistance of the earth. So around 15 centimeters this charcoal and salt mixture is poured, so which is having a dimension of 90 centimeters depth, and this earth plate is connected to GI pipe, and copper wire is connected to the earth plate, or generally in some cases it is also connected to the GI pipe, and that copper wire is connected to the copper plate. So this is your ground level. So on the ground level, generally a cement chamber is constructed to protect these iron pipes. A cement chamber is constructed and it is closed with an cast iron cover. In some cases, cast iron cover is not used. So you can see beside our college building, there are lot of earth pits around the college building. You might have also noticed the conductor that is connected to the earth rod. So this earth rod, part of this earth rod is visible outside earth pit. A funnel or measure can be arranged for pouring water. So frequently this earth pit has to be supplied with water, so that maintains the moisture in the earth pit, which will maintain the conductivity of the earth. So this earth wire is connected to the third pin of the three pin socket. So if there is any leakage current, that leakage current will pass through the copper wire and to the earth. So generally this oil and salt mixture is provided to increase the conductivity of earth or to decrease the resistance of the earth. Generally it is maintained less than 5 ohms. So this is called as plate earthing. Since a plate is used, it is called as plate earthing. So you'll see the point. A copper plate of 60 centimeters into 60 centimeters into 3.18 mm, or you can also use a GI plate of dimensions 60 centimeters into 60 centimeters into 6.35 mm. So you can see the difference in thickness here. If it is a copper plate, it is 3.18 mm. If it is a GI plate, it is 6.35 mm is used for everything. The plate is buried into the ground not less than 3 meters from the ground level. So a 3 meters pit is dug and the plate and pipe is inserted into the ground, and a mixture of coal and charcoal is poured around the plate, and the pit is closed again, keeping the one end of the pipe above. The earth plate is embedded in the alternate layers of coal and charcoal for thickness of 15 mm. So alternate layers of coal and charcoal is poured around the earth plate. So this is a diagram showing the plate earthing. Next is pipe earthing. So in the pipe earthing, a GI pipe is placed from top to bottom. So this is a simple diagram indicating the pipe earthing. So in a all the earthing methods, the common thing is they will dig a pit of not less than 3 meters and they will place plate and GI pipe in case of plate earthing, and a pipe in case of pipe earthing. So a GI pipe is placed and an earth wire is connected to the GI pipe. Here some holes are made to the GI pipe, and again a mixture of charcoal and salt is arranged to increase the conductivity of the earth. So you'll see the points regarding pipe earthing. So earth electrode made of GI means galvanized iron. So why galvanization is done means to avoid the rusting of the iron. So galvanized iron pipe of 38 mm in diameter and a length of 2 meters depending on the current, with 12 mm holes. So holes are made on the surface of the pipe. That means the purpose is whenever water is poured through those holes, the water will come out and will maintain the conductivity of the earth pit.
12 mm holes on the surface is placed upright at the depth of 4.75 meters in a permanently wet ground. So the depth here is 4.75 meters. 38 mm is the diameter and 2 mm is the length of the rod. So this is the case in case of pipe earthing. So simply a pipe is placed in a ground. A pipe is placed in a ground to provide the earthing purpose. So that is about pipe earthing. Next is rod earthing. So in the rod earthing, same an earth pit is dug. In rod earthing, a rod is hammered into the ground. So here instead of a pipe, a rod is placed. It may be a copper rod or iron rod. So a rod is placed into the earth pit. So this is earth rod, earth pit. This is earth pit, and this is earth lid, that is wire which is connected to earth rod. This is ground level. So this is called as rod earthing. We'll see the points. So a copper rod of 8.55 mm, that is half inch diameter, or 16 mm diameter of galvanized iron having 1 inch diameter. So it may be a copper rod or an galvanized iron rod can be used. If it is a copper rod, it is half inch diameter. If it is a galvanized iron steel, it should be 1 inch. It's a hollow pipe, can also be used. J pipe of length 2.5 meters are buried upright into the earth manually with the help of pneumatic hammer. So it is buried, the copper rod or iron rod is buried into the earth using a hammer. So it can be hammered to earth. The length of embedded electrodes in the soil reduces earth resistance to a desired value. So since the embedded rod is kept inside the earth, it reduces the resistance of the soil. So this is called as rod earthing. Next kind of earthing is called as a strip or wire earthing. So in this, a strip of wire is placed. So in this method of earthing, strip electrodes of cross section not less than 25 mm into 1.5 mm, that is 1 inch into 0.06 inch. Is buried into a horizontal trench of minimum depth 0.5 meters. So a trench is dug here horizontally and these strips are placed at a depth of 0.5 meters. So this type of earthing is used where earth bed has rocky soil. So generally in rocky soil kind of soils, strip or wire earthing is used. So generally the earth resistance should be less than 5 ohms. So you can check the earth resistance using devices. So generally the resistance should be less than 5 ohms. So basing on the application, it requires different types of resistances. Like power plants should have less than 5 ohms. Likewise households should have some kind of resistance less than 15 ohms. So these are the requirements. Basing on this, you should maintain proper earthing. So generally the earth pit is watered regularly to maintain the moisture, that is to maintain the conductivity of the earth. If at all earth pit is not watered, earth pit will lose the conductivity and there will be no use of earthing. So that is about strip or rod earthing.